Hey the people, how doing? So, it is time for us to review the OnePlus 10 Pro. I know it took a little bit of time, but, well, I really had to gather my thoughts on how I really felt about this phone because it has been, let's say, subverting expectations left and right, and basically, there's a lot to talk about. So, the way I want to structure this review is, you know, we're going to take a look at the good stuff, then the average stuff, you know, not quite impressive, but not bad either. And then finally, we're gonna have to talk about the ugly as well. It sounds grim, maybe it is, that's gonna depend, but for now, let's begin with what I would consider to be the best thing about the OnePlus 10 Pro. Like, OnePlus knocked this thing out the park. No surprise, it's the design. Like, I'll be entirely honest, this is a design that completely speaks to me. It checks all of the boxes that would make me consider it to be an incredible look for a smartphone, and it does just that. OnePlus generally goes for a much more subtle design, especially with the camera module, and the fact that they changed it up, it works really well in my opinion here. It does look quite inspired by the S21 Ultra from last year. Not that it's a bad thing, it works, and it definitely looks really good in person. And the fact that it's dual tone with glossy on the camera module itself and just incredible matte finish all around, it looks even better in my opinion because of that. Up front, I mean, it's a very typical Android flagship. We have a hole punch display, very minor bezels, and it's curved. Now, I know not everybody loves curved designs, and I personally have no problem. I actually like the way they look, and the, you know, phantom touches and all that jazz. Never really had any issues with that, with any smartphone really. So yeah, for the most part, I think the design is A-class, and you know, it just looks good. It feels incredible in the hand, very comfortable. Obviously, it's a OnePlus device after all. So that's the very first good thing about the OnePlus 10 Pro. The second would be performance and battery life. Actually, I would consider battery life to be first, because believe it or not, this phone right here, it has incredible battery. I really did not fathom it would be this good, because on paper we have a 500 mAh upgrade compared to last year. It doesn't really sound like much because, you know, it's 4500 to 5000 mAh. How much more battery life could it really be? Turns out, a hell of a lot, because this phone right here, it beats out the S22 Ultra in battery life, like hands down is better. Like every single day, I got around 6 to 6.5 hours of screen on time easily, and still had 30 to 35% battery left. So that means if I wanted to push it, I could go for a day and a half of battery life with ease. Or, you know, if I'm really going ham and I really want to use this phone in a single day and just kill it, I could basically go for over 7 to 7.5 hours, more than that. So that really goes to show that battery, this is another thing that OnePlus really knocked it out the park with, and honestly, it's quite impressive. It sort of makes up for some of the other shortcomings about this device. I'll get into what I'm exactly talking about in a few moments, but yeah, for now, battery is just incredible. Even standby time, it is markedly better than something like the S22 Ultra once again. Both have always on displays, but this phone just drains less battery throughout the day with always on display turned on. Now, you could go crazy and just turn off always on display and get even more battery life over a long period of usage, but to be entirely honest, it's really not needed because this phone's battery is just amazing. Now, finally, we also got to touch on performance. I mean, it's obviously incredible. It's a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 and it works really well. Heating issues, I really didn't encounter anything other than the one time when I was just shooting back to back 4K, 4K 60 and then 8K video in the afternoon sun, and that's during this summer heat. So it's pretty obvious that I would have run into some issues there. I mean, I was shooting with the S22 Ultra as well for the camera comparison, and yeah, both of them heated to the point that I couldn't really hold them after a while. But yeah, point is, for the most part, you know, in normal conditions, you're not going to run into any issues whatsoever. And even the little bit of stuttering that we had, I believe I mentioned that in the OnePlus 9 Pro's review last year, even that's gone. So now it's just a buttery smooth experience through and through. You're obviously not going to run into any issues on the performance side of things. So that's most of the good stuff. Now, I mean, yes, you could consider OxygenOS to be an incredible thing about the OnePlus 10 Pro as well. It's also going to be one of the reasons that I feel why a lot of people might actually go for the OnePlus 10 Pro, despite some of its drawbacks. But for the most part, you know, there are quite a few really good things about this device. No doubt about that. It is, after all, OnePlus's flagship at this very moment. But there are areas where they could have improved a little bit, at least, in my opinion, you know. Basically, I'm talking about the display. It's good. It's really nice. It's essentially the same display that we had last year, with maybe some minor improvements here and there. But for the most part, you know, it's got most of the bells and whistles that you'd expect from a flagship in 2022. You know, it's got fairly good brightness. It's not really winning any awards in that regard. I wish the brightness was a little bit higher. Like, I can tell the difference between this one and the S22 Ultra. Other than that, we got 1440p, we got the variable 120Hz, you know, it's all good. We have the HDR 10, 10 Plus, 10-bit color, but I wish OnePlus would have gone ahead and given us more brightness and just tuned the HDR a little bit more. Because, you know, SDR content, you know, YouTube videos and all that jazz is gonna look amazing on the OnePlus 10 Pro, but HDR, I still feel like it looks a bit too flat and the contrast is not really there in HDR. Comparing side by side with the S22 Ultra, just to confirm my opinion on this, and it's very obvious, the S22 Ultra has much punchier colors and it looks more pleasing to my eyes at least. So yes, the display, you know, it could be better than what we're getting right now, but I still feel like it's good enough to the point that you're not gonna really feel the need to complain. I'm complaining mostly because I've been using the S22 and then I switched to this, so I can see the differences a lot more than anyone normally would. Along with that, we also have the speakers, of course. You know, it's really good stereo speakers, works really well, very loud, and you know, compared to the S22 Ultra, I would say it's maybe a little bit more tinny, so I wish they would have improved that a little bit, but it's hardly a complaint at this point. And the reason I'm using the S22 Ultra so much is because it's the only real reference I have for a 2022 flagship. And also, I do want to mention the fact that the fingerprint scanner has been moved up. Much easier to reach right now compared to what we had last year. That one was kind of annoying. This one, it makes life easier. But with that said, now it is finally time for us to talk about the ugly. It's the cameras, believe it or not, and if you haven't seen any of my camera comparisons, you might be feeling like, what is wrong with me and why am I talking like the cameras are actually bad on this phone? I'd recommend you check them out before or after this video, that's up to you. But yeah, the link is in the description. But the problem with the cameras is that OnePlus decided to change the one thing that was just utterly and ridiculously incredible about their device last year. I'm talking about the ultrawide camera, of course. We had this just bonkers, amazing 50 megapixel sensor last year. And the reason it was so good is because it gave you some of the best detail you could get. Whether you're using 50 megapixel mode or not, the detail from the ultrawide camera was amazing. It gave you really nice and beautiful macro photography. It gave you just out of this world video quality. You know, the sensor's quality was so good that the video itself inherently looked amazing last year. Then you take into account the fact that we had amazing 4K 60, we had amazing 8K ultrawide, which is by far still the best in the OnePlus 9 Pro. So it just goes to show that the ultrawide was the strongest part of OnePlus's camera system last year. This year, it's the opposite, believe it or not, because that is just how things went down. I don't quite understand why it happened like that, but it did. So what I'm talking about is that OnePlus decided to switch out the ultrawide that we had last year to this 150 degree field of view ultrawide. Still 50 megapixels, but obviously having 150 degree field of view means incredible amount of distortion. No one wants that. So getting normal ultrawide shots is only possible if you crop in. And we all know what happens when we have to crop in, especially on the ultrawide camera, because the results are, well, I was gonna say less than ideal, but let's face it, it's far worse than that. Because I did not go into any of the camera comparisons expecting the ultrawide camera on the OnePlus 10 Pro to perform as poorly as it did. I know, it might sound harsh, but that's the truth. I'm being completely honest here, because think about it. All we're getting for this change is the 150 degree field of view. Is it cool? It is. It's kind of also a gimmick. But what are we losing? We're losing macro. That's right, no more macro on the OnePlus 10 Pro. None of that incredible close-up shots that you could take before, it's all gone. And then along with that, we are also losing out on a ton of detail, whether you use 50 megapixel mode or not. The S22 Ultra's 12 megapixel ultra wide, which is very obviously not as high quality as a sensor as the OnePlus 10 Pro, it gives you better detail, less grain, even in videos. And yes, obviously the detail in videos is a problem now on the OnePlus 10 Pro for the ultra wide again. And also no 8K 30 on the ultra wide. We don't even get 4K 60 on the ultra wide. Now, I completely understand if you say that, okay, the ultra wide 8K, no one's gonna use it. It's a huge file size. No one wants to deal with that. Obviously, but a lot of people like to use 4K 60 on the ultra wide. You know, it's really stable. You get smooth video. You can slow it down later. The resolution is good. And you cannot do that with the OnePlus 10 Pro. I mean, that is pretty insane if you ask me, for a feature as nice as 4K 60 to just be abandoned like that. I'm not even sure why it was abandoned, but it was, and you cannot use it far as I can tell. And of course, I could always talk about, you know, how good the cameras have gotten compared to last year with the software and all that. It has, you know, I feel like it's gotten a little bit more consistent. There are still issues. I mean, exposure in video can be quite inconsistent sometimes. But let's face it, the camera on, let's say, last year's OnePlus 9 Pro, it was never, you know, winning awards in being consistent or being extremely realistic and basically color accurate or anything like that. That was never really the case. What was, however, the case is that OnePlus gave us so many features last year. Like, there were incredible things like ultra-wide 8K and incredible 4K 60, normal 4K video being amazingly detailed. I mean, the list goes on. And right now, a lot of those amazing features are just gone, which removes the incentive that I would consider a lot of people had for buying the OnePlus 10 Pro for its cameras. It's next to impossible to really recommend it to someone who might be looking for a really nice flagship with a really good camera as well. I mean, that's not to say that the phone itself is bad and it's impossible for anyone to use it and be satisfied with it. That's not the case. I'm talking about most of those people who look at OnePlus devices and they feel like they're gonna get a really good camera for their money. That, be entirely honest, it's not gonna happen here. It didn't happen for me, and there's a very good chance that it's not gonna happen for you. Now, all we have is a main camera which works fairly well. It's not bad, it's not crazy incredible or anything like that either. And we have this 3x optical zoom camera, which is fairly low quality, 8 megapixel. You can't even take portrait shots with it. So for the most part, the camera system is just not flushed out anymore. It just doesn't have enough to offer for the flagship price tag. But there is one particular audience for this, far as I can come up with. I feel like if all you're looking for is a OnePlus device because of its Oxygen OS, or maybe you like the design, whatever it is. But if that's all you're looking for and you do not care about these cameras, then yeah, this is going to be a stellar device for you. The reason I say that is because, you know, other than the cameras, if you look at it, it's got a great display, it's got an amazing design, it's got utterly incredible battery life, performance is fantastic. And I'm running out of adjectives at this point, so basically what I'm trying to say is there is a very small audience, it's a niche audience, I would say, but yeah, it's still going to be worth their while. But despite all of that, I would say there is a small silver lining. Well, sort of. It's not for the OnePlus 10 Pro, not in the slightest, because I'm talking about the OnePlus 10 Ultra. And the reason I'm talking about that is because if you look at the 10 Pro, it's basically an incredible flagship with a very lackluster camera. What it really means is that OnePlus has figured out how to make incredible smartphones, but the camera department is still a little iffy. So maybe that's what the OnePlus 10 Ultra is going to do. You know, I'm really hoping at least that the OnePlus 10 Ultra is going to come out with these incredible you know, camera features and upgrades that are just going to blow the 10 Pro out of the water and hopefully some of the competition as well. And you know, just for the sake of it, let's see what we can expect from the OnePlus 10 Ultra. I know this is supposed to be the OnePlus 10 Pro review, but we're basically past that at this point. But yeah, the OnePlus 10 Ultra, what I wish we can get is the good old ultra-wide camera back in place. Just get rid of this 150 degree field of view. It's really not worth it. There are far too many sacrifices and it doesn't make sense. But where OnePlus absolutely requires an upgrade is in the zoom department. Now, honestly, I'm not saying that OnePlus 10 Ultra needs to have a 10x zoom like the S22 Ultra, but what it really requires is a good upgrade to the 3x zoom. You know, either give us a nice 5x zoom camera with a good sensor. In the name of God, we really need a good sensor. This 8 megapixel stuff, it's not gonna work out. Ideally, I would actually prefer a 3x zoom camera with a good sensor, because then we can use it for portraits. You know, considering the fact that the option is enabled. It has not been enabled thus far on the 10 Pro, so I really hope they do that on the OnePlus 10 Ultra. And well, you know, essentially what I really want from the OnePlus 10 Ultra is for OnePlus to finally be able to properly compete side by side with all the other Ultras and Pro Pluses and Pro Maxes out there, because the 10 Pro, it's obviously not the phone for that purpose now, is it? So with that said, I do hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, do hit that like button. And well, I know this review was kind of different, but I still think that it was definitely worth making, and it's definitely worth understanding the fact that OnePlus might just have a new trick up their sleeve with the OnePlus 10 Ultra for 2022 at least. So with that said, I'll be seeing you guys soon enough. Cheers.